It takes 10 days less than the time taken by B to finish a piece of work. If both A and B together can finish the work in 12 days, find the time taken by B to finish the piece of a work. So how do we do that? We have to consider in these type of question one day of work. So we need to assume that because we have to find about B, so let us assume that B finished the work in X days. B in X days. So X days, B's work, right? So for one day, what will be B's work? It will be 1 by X, right? I just took one, this X, so you can say that X, B's work, you can divide both sides by X. You get one day. This is one day work you have to find out. One day work will be 1 by X. I hope you got the idea. That is simply, you know, if 5 day pricing, 5 day pricing is say $10. So one day pricing will be what, right? So 1 day will be, if you have to divide by 5. This is simply like this only. So B is 1 day work is 1 by X. Now A takes 10 days less than of B to finish the same piece of work. So if X is the day we chose for B, for A, we have to choose the A, 1 day work will be. Because B is 1 by X, A will be 1 by X minus 10 because it is given. A takes 10 days less than the time taken by B to finish a piece of work, right? So now if A and B together can finish the work in 12 days, that means, because this is 12 days, same work in 12 days, A, if you see A and B, they together complete the work in 12 days. Say some work. So 1 day work of A and B together will be 1 by 12 of that work. So 1 by 12 is the combined work. But what is the combined one? A plus B. A plus B. 1 by X plus 1 by X minus 10. See, the idea of this question, all of this question is simply that you have to find the 1 day work. And that will be only possible when you take the reciprocal of this. Okay. So this X, if you assume it has to be 1 by X. If you take X minus 10, you have to take 1 by X minus 10. If the days are given, that is 12 days is for whole work. For 1 day, that what will be the work? 1 by 12, like this. So this is the equation. So you can solve this easily. X minus 10, X goes here. You have X minus 10 equal to 1 by 12. So X and X is 2X minus 10. Bring 12 here, this one, and take this here. This will be X square minus 10X. So what do you get? 12 into 2, 24X minus 120 is equal to X square minus 10X. I am bringing these two here. That will be minus 24X plus 120. So X square minus 10 minus 24 is minus 34. And this is plus 120. So 30 into 4 is 120, right? So what we can do for 34x, we can write minus 30x minus 4x. Take x common, x minus 30 will be there. Take minus 4 common, x minus 30 will be there. So what do you get? X minus 4 and x minus 30. So x will be either 30 or x will be equal to 4. But if you see that the value of x cannot be less than 10. The value of x cannot be less than 10. See, if you want to compute x minus 10, and if it is less than 10, 4 minus 10 will be equal to minus 6. That is not logical. That is not logical. So we have to assume 30. So now, x is the 30. That is, B need 30 days to finish certain work. If two pipes function simultaneously, a reservoir will be filled in 12 hours. One pipe fills the reservoir 10 hours faster than the other. How many hours will the second pipe take to fill the reservoir? So we assume that one takes X hour, the other will have X plus 10, or you can take otherwise also. right? If you can take this one as x, this will be, you can subtract 10 here. So both ways you can do. So we'll follow the first one. That is, one is x, one is x plus 10. One is x plus 10. Now, both can together fit in 12 hours. See, we have to find that what is filled in 1 hour. This is in hour. How many hours are we don't know x plus 10x, but how many in 1 hour? So this one, in 1 hour, the amount is filled is x, that is the portion of it is filled in by first five. The second one, this is the first one for x1. X minus 10, x plus 10, for 1 hour it will be 1 by x plus 10, right? And if two pipes simultaneously fill a reservoir will be filled in 12 hours. That is, 12 hours is, the time is 12 hours. So, how much portion of the reservoir is filled by together, that is in 1 hour, is simply 1 by 12. See, 12 hours, some portion is filled. So, in 1 hour, what is being filled? 1 by 12? Same thing. So, if we add these two, this will be 1 by 12 hour. That is 1 by x plus 1 by x plus 1 by x plus 10 is equal to 1 by 12. This is what we have to solve. So, x plus 10 will go here. X will go here. This will be x plus 10 plus x. And this will be equal to 1 by 12. So, this will be x into x plus 10. This goes here, and x plus 10 into x plus 10 plus x, that is 2x plus 10, we multiply 12 with this. So you get this one is 24x plus 120 equal to, so let me solve this from the scratch. This is x plus 10 plus x, but this is x into x plus 10, that is x square plus 10x. This is 1 by 12. So this becomes 2x plus 10, I'm multiplying 12 here. This is equal to x square plus 10x. This is 24x plus 120 again equal to x square plus 10x. I am bringing both here. So this will be minus 24x minus 120. So x square, and this is, see, this is 10x minus 24x. What do you get? Minus 14x. And then you have minus 120 equal to 0. 120 can be written as 20 into 6. This will be x square plus, you can write it as, minus 14 can be written as plus 6x minus 20x minus 120 equal to 0. So x plus 6 minus 20, x plus 6 equal to 0. So the factors are x plus 6 and x minus 20 equal to 0. Here you get x equal to 6. From here you get x equal to 20. X equal to minus 6. Minus 6 you cannot take negative value. X equal to 20 you are going to take. X equal to 20 is the hour. So x is 20, and what is x plus 10? It will be 20 plus 10, that is 30. This will be 10, this will be 20, and this will be 30. Okay. Two water taps together can fill a tank in 9 3 by 8. The tap of a larger diameter takes 10 hours less than the smaller one to fill the tank separately. So if you take smaller, it for how many hours it takes, if you take smaller as x, the larger will take 10 hours less. So x minus 10. Find the time in which each tap can be filled separately the tank. So here we have combined, that is x minus 10, it fills in 10 hours. That is, this x minus 10 is for the diameter which is higher. So higher diameter, say higher diameter take x minus 10 hours. So for 1 hour, how much it is going to fill? 1 by x minus 10. And the, say, lower diameter, it takes how much? X hour. So in 1 hour, how much is this going to fill? It will be 1 by x portion. So when you combine these two, 1 by x minus 10 portion plus 1 by x portion, this is going to be the total water taps together can fill a tank in this much. So this is the time, total time, 9 3 by 8. We can write it as 8 9 is 72. 72 plus 3 is 75. 75 by 8. So this is 75 by 8 hour. So in 1 hour, it will be 1 by 75 by 8. That is, it is 8 by 75. So this is equal to 1 by You can set 8 by 75, you can write. So this is going to be your, this is 8 by 75, what I explained you. And this is 1 by x minus 10 plus 1 by x. So what do you get? X minus 10 goes here, x goes here, x into x minus 10 remains in the denominator. This becomes 2x minus 10, you multiply 7x, 75 by 2x minus 10, you multiply 8 with x square minus 10x, x square minus 10x, that is 8x square minus 80x. Now I bring both here, it will be x square, 8x square minus 80x and minus 150x. So 80 minus 150 is minus 8 minus, minus 80 minus 150 is minus 230 and you have plus 750. Now you can divide both sides by 4. So this is the equation you get. So it is, if you are not able to solve using factor, just take a equal to 4, b equal to minus 115 and c equal to 375. And b square minus 4 is c, minus b plus minus under root b square minus 4 is c by 2hc, Dharacharya formula you use when you find that these are the values, that is plus minus you can take. So when we compute this x, when we take 115 plus under root 85 by 8, and when we take 115 minus under root 85 by 8, one time it is going to come as 13.22 and one time it is going to come as 15.52, right? So just ignore this. If you see, x is going to come as, x you can take as 15 or x you can take as 13.22. So of course, you can take x minus 10, that is, this will be x minus 10 will be 5.52 and this is going to be 3.22. So if you take either of this one or this one, you can take any of this because x is of course greater than 10, because you have to see x should not be less than 10. So this is the answer. Both are the answers. Two pipes running together can fill the tank in 11 1/9 minutes. So if one pipe takes 5 minutes more than the other to fill the tank separately, find the time in which each pipe would fill the tank separately. So the question is almost same. That is, if we take the time by the faster pipe, that is x minute, then the portion will be filled in, which is in 1 minute. If this is total is x minute, the portion in 1 minute will be 1 by x. Now the slower pipe takes 5 minutes longer. So you can assume this to be x plus 5 minutes, but the portion filled in 1 minute is 1 by x plus 5. You have to divide this by 1 pi by x plus 5 to find out the portion in 1 minute. This is also for 1 minute, this is also for 1 minute. So when you add them, that is 1 by x plus 1 by x plus 5, this is going to be this much minute, the portion in this much minute. So 11 1 by 9 is nothing but 9 into 11 is 99, 99 plus 1 is 100, 100 by 9. So this is the minutes. So in 1 minute, how much portion will be filled? This will be 1 by 100 by 9. So it is going to be 9 by 100. So this addition will be equal to 9 by 100. So you need to solve this. That is, it goes like this. Let me write it again. This 1 by x plus 1 by x plus 5 equal to 9 by 100. This goes here, x plus 5. This goes here, x by x into x plus 5, so x square plus 5x. Now we need to multiply this by 100 and this by 9. This will be 2x plus 5, so 100 into 2x plus 5, and this is going to be 9x square plus 45x, and this will be 200x plus 500. This is going to be 9x square plus 45x. I'm bringing these two here, minus 200x minus 500. So you get 9x square, and 45 minus 200 is what? It's going to be minus 155x. This is minus 500. So you can write this 155 as what? You can write it as 180 into 25, because 500 into 9 is also 180 into 9 into 500 is equal to 180 into 25. So you can write 155 as 180 into 180 and 25, so that you get 155. So you can write minus 155 as minus 180 plus 25. You can take 9x common from here, x minus 20 will be there. You can take 25 common here, x minus 20 will be there. So x minus 20 and 9x plus 25. So x is going to be 20 from here, and x is going to be minus 25 by 9 from here. But you cannot take negative, x cannot be negative, time cannot be negative. So x is 20 you are going to take. for the faster pipe, and x plus 5, that is 25. This is going to be for the faster, this is for the slower pipe will be 25, slower will be right here, and this is for the faster pipe.